Where do you see now the transduction in the transfer of genetic material from one bacteria to another bacteria? To understand this, we're going to first talk about the cycle of the bacteriophage. We have two kinds of bacteriophage, templated and virulent. The templated can replicate in the lytic or lysogenic cycles, and the virulent only in the lytic cycle. Alright, so let's begin with a virulent factor in which we have a lytic cycle. So here's the bacteria, DNA of the bacteria, and here we have a bacteriophage that is infecting the bacteria. Here's the DNA of the bacteriophage. It inserts here into the cytoplasm. Then the machinery of the bacteria makes the replication of this DNA. We have a lot now. Well, the bacteria has now inside a lot of DNAs and RNAs and proteins made by these DNAs, that is, proteins that are codified in these DNAs. So the replication rate of the material of the DNA of the bacteriophage is very high compared to that of the cell. Then the cell is going to be lysed, and as the cell lyses, here we destroy the DNA of the cell and everything, but releases a bacteriophage that now assemble these DNAs with corresponding proteins, and we have bacteriophage. This is the normal replication of this bacteriophage, of this virulent bacteriophage in a lytic cycle. This is normal. If there is some bacteriophage that instead of taking this DNA or this DNA or some copy of the DNA made from the original DNA of the bacteriophage, instead of that takes this, that this is a DNA, a part of the DNA of the bacteria, of the live bacteria, so now this DNA is here. And now this bacteriophage can go, as the others, can go here to another bacteria. But instead of inserting a DNA as this bacteriophage did, this bacteriophage carries DNA from the bacteria, not from the virus, from the bacteriophage. It's from the bacteria. Then it inserts here. And then through homologous recombination, this is going to be inserted into the material genetics of the DNA of the bacteria. And so now this bacteria has genes that didn't have before. So now we have a transfer from DNA of this bacteria to this bacteria. This was a error in package. Instead of this bacteriophage packed this DNA, took this DNA, this piece of DNA from the lysed bacteria. Alright, this is a lytic cycle. This was the lytic cycle. This was a error in the lytic cycle that results in transfer from DNA to this, from this bacteria to this bacteria. This is a virulent virus, bacteriophage. Now we're going to talk about the template and the lysogenic. Here we have the bacteria, DNA, the bacteriophage, but now the bacteriophage puts this DNA and is going to be inserted, well, at least it's going to be bind here to this DNA of the bacteria. And in this DNA, if this DNA is transcribed quickly and translated quickly in the lambda, that is the repressor protein that is inhibiting the replication of this DNA, as opposed to the lytic cycle in which the bacteria was all the time replicating that DNA. Here, because of this lambda protein that was transcribed quickly as this DNA enters here, so now this replication is stopped. So in each replication, each normal replication of the bacteria, when it gives to bacteria, can give also the DNA, but it's going to give this DNA with this DNA that is inserted here. So this is how the templated bacteriophage replicates in a lysogenic cycle. When there is some error of this lysogenic cycle, that is, if UV light or something damage this lambda protein that is here, is suppressing the replication of just this DNA, and for that there is no replication of the DNA, and just the DNA of the bacteriophage replicates as the bacteria replicates, as opposed to the lytic phage, in which all the time was a replication of that DNA. Now, if we have a error in this lambda protein, that is, if there is a mutation in this DNA codifying for this lambda, or if there is UV light or something that damage this lambda protein or the interaction of this DNA, so this DNA is excised. Now it's here in the cytoplasm, and the templated phage enters now in a lytic cycle. So now it's as the previous one. It produces a lot of DNA, RNA, proteins. This cell now, this bacteria is now lysed, and we release, well, the bacteria release bacteriophage with this DNA. And then this can go to infect other cells, and the same history. So it was first a lysogenic cycle, and if something wrong happens, becomes a lytic cycle. Now, in the lysogenic cycle, we can have a error. This is, yes, in the if the lysogenic cycle fails, then it goes to the lytic cycle. But in this excision of the DNA, in which now this DNA that was inserted here, now is going here to the cytoplasm, in this excision of DNA, we can excise, instead of all this DNA, all the DNA from the bacteriophage, what is going to be excised is just a part of the, here, just a part of the DNA. Let's say that this part is excised, this part of the DNA of the bacteriophage, but also this part. So it's all this what was excised, instead of this. So the thing that was excised is a part of the bacteriophage DNA and part of the bacteria DNA. So now this, we have it here. Here. And now is this what's going to be replicated at a very high rate. And yes, the bacteria is going to be lysed, and the bacteriophage that arrive from here are not going to be bacteriophage like this, because the DNA that was excised was not this, was this and part of the bacterial DNA. So in the in all these new progeny, in this new progeny, in this new progeny, the bacteriophage contains DNA in part from the bacteriophage from the original bacteriophage, but also DNA from the bacteria. So we have this DNA. All this bacteriophage has bacterial DNA. And then this goes to infect another cell, another bacteria. Here is this new bacteria. The bacteriophage comes. And this DNA that was here passes here. And again inserted here and could go into a lysogenic cycle, and if it fails, in a lytic cycle. But now we have transferred this genetic material of the bacteria, specifically just this part, to that bacteria. This is the mechanism through which many exotoxins from bacteria are acquired. We say A, B, C, D. A for the erythrogenic toxin from Streptococcus, Streptococcus pyogenes, that is erythrogenic toxin A through C. B, botulinum toxin. C, cholera toxin. D, diphtheria Toxin. Ah, we also have some one of Shigella toxin. Alright. But so we have first a normal cycle is a lysogenic cycle. If it fails, it goes into a lytic cycle. But if in the transition from lysogenic to lytic cycle in which there is a excision of the DNA, if there is a error in excising the DNA, and so some bacterial DNA is excised, then this is going to produce a progeny of bacteriophage in which the DNA is passed from the bacteria and then goes to infect the other bacteria, and this is another way of transfer. So from both errors, a lytic phage error or a error in a lysogenic phage, that is, let's say in the transition from here to here, we can have bacterial DNA that is being put in the bacteriophage, and then when that bacteriophage infects the other cell, the other bacteria is transferring DNA from one bacteria to another. In this case, in the error from the templated phage, we are also going to insert this DNA, well, the bacteria is going to insert this DNA into here, at something called the site-specific recombination. So it's going to insert it here, there, because, but it is in a specifically site, but that is called site-specific recombination. This is called specialized transduction when it is for a templated bacteriophage, and when it is from a lytic phage, it's called generalized transduction. This is because in the previous example, in the example of the virulent or lytic cycle in which there was an error and the lyse bacteria with that DNA, then some of the lyse DNA of the bacteria can be packed into some bacteriophage and go to infect another cell. This DNA that has been packed from the bacteria can be any part of the bacterial DNA, so it is generalized because there is no privilege for DNA that can go. There is no preference, no nothing. Every part of the broken DNA has the same probability of being packed by error in a bacteriophage. But in this DNA is only inserted into a specific site of the bacterial DNA, that is between here, between the gall and ovi skin. So when this excision occurs and there is the error in which the excision is also from bacterial DNA, what's going to be excised is or the gall gene or the ovi gene. And so these are the only bacterial DNA or genes that can be put in the new bacteriophage and go to being passed to another cell. So this is a specialized transduction because there are just special genes that can go. These are just GAL or OVI. And this is, for example, in Escherichia coli.